the following contest on the Power Hour is for the World's Heavyweight title. It is set for one fall of TV time remaining. Making his way to the ring area, the challenger. He weighs in at 240 pounds. From the great state of Minnesota, this is the Z-Man.
What a matchup for this young man. And this here,
his opponent is a six-time and current world heavyweight champion. He weighs in at 241 pounds, and this gentleman represents the Four Horsemen. From the Queen City in Charlotte, North Carolina, America, this is the Nature Boy.
Making his way to the ring, a man that many consider the greatest world's heavyweight champion of all time in our sport. And what an opportunity for a fellow native Minnesotan, Ric Flair, originally from Minneapolis, Minnesota. That's where the Z-Man grew up. And I'm sure as a Z-Man watched Ric Flair's career skyrocket, he would have never thought that he would have a chance on national TV to wrestle for all the gold.
Greatest heavyweight champion of all time. Sure he is, but what has he done for me lately?
Well, I want to tell you something. He will be in the cage with his teammates, Sting and Arn Anderson, against Muta, Dragon Master, and Sawyer Tuesday night. And Corny Tuesday night, something most interesting. We are going to have our 900 number coverage. The hotline will be covering that event live. And after every match, the winners will go to the 900 mine, and the fans can hear them live. So it's very, very unique. Much expanded coverage of the wrestling hotline. So if you can't see the event, or if you'd like to watch it and listen to it on the hotline, we encourage you to do that.
So you mean if the Road Warriors wrestle the Skyscrapers and the Road Warriors win the match, then we could call up the 900 number, or you can, I wouldn't call them, and hear the Road Warriors. Is that what you're saying?
Yes. You and I are going to be busy because we're going to be doing the broadcast. But I'm sure thousands of fans will want to hear what the Road Warriors have to say right after the match. Now let's focus on this. The World's Heavyweight Championship. Ric Flair and the Z-Man. This should be a great scientific event.
Tuesday night, I'll probably have time while you go off on one of your tangents to call the 900 number for 5 or 6 minutes.
I'll try not to do that, James. I want you to be happier. I'm under a little duress that you're so uncomfortable going to the great communities here in America.
The only reason I'm going to Corpus Christi is to see the main event with Flair and Sting and Arn Anderson in the cage against both Sawyer the Great, Muta, and the Dragon Master. Otherwise than that, I wouldn't go to Corpus Christi. There's too many Mexicans down there.
Please.
Oh, it's true. Do you know what? 10,000 Mexicans attacked the Alamo.
No, why? 10,000 Mexicans attacked the Alamo.
They only had one pickup truck.
All right. Well, collar and elbow tie, a Flair side headlock on the Z-Man. As we said before we were interrupted, this should be a great scientific event. Flair did not want to disappoint the fans. Luger, the pompous one, says, I'm going to boycott until Tuesday night.
Come on, back it up.
He's going to be in Folks Grill Tuesday night, and that's all he's going to do. I'm sure he's going to come down there and be in Folks Grill, and he's going to observe Ric Flair's cage match with three of the most dangerous men in wrestling.
Yeah, the last time that Luger was just going to be around doing some observing toward the latter part of the last clash, we saw what he did. So if you think lightning can't strike twice, then you're wrong. I smell a rat Tuesday night.
All I saw at the last Clash of Champions was Lex Luger offering Ric Flair and Sting a seat.
Yeah.
Of course, he offered it to them over their head.
Flair picking that leg up. We know Flair, the past master, the greatest proponent of the figure four leg lock in the history of the sport. And the Z-Man shot off to the other side. Good football tackle by the Z-Man. This outstanding youngster Hole for hole with Ric Flair. A great reversal. Good counter wrestling. And a drop kick by the Z-Man. Flair in trouble. Side headlock. The champion is down. 1-2 in a near fall.
Oh, don't go so excited, Jim.
Oh, man.
I'll tell you exactly. I know Flair like a book. I studied him from ringside when Beautiful Bobby wrestled him for the world title. I've studied him for years. Ric Flair right now is suckering this kid. He's doing it in a nice way, of course, but he's suckering him. He's such an experienced veteran. He knows that he's going to wear Zenk out early.
Flair rolled him over on his shoulders. We'll see if that strategy is indeed true. Flair going for that pinning predicament there. The Z-Man, the wide stance, leaning on Flair. Nice side headlock. Well, these guys are both in magnificent condition, very much indicative of the tremendous athletic contest that we see here in the NWA each and every week, especially here on the Power Hour. I hope you'll get in a better mood so you'll be back here next week. What am I saying? I hope he comes back. What's wrong with me?
What is wrong with you?
I don't know. It's been my diet or something. I don't know.
You know, I've been having some conversations with Ted about you.
Ted who?
Ted Turner, idiot. Like I said before, holy mackerel.
He actually took time to talk to you.
You know, he actually thought you were the world's greatest wrestling announcer until I told him a few things.
Well, thanks a lot.
Well, just some slight critiques.